Hello everyone and welcome to SSW4LL 2011 Social Semantic Web for Lifelong Learners, a course that will be held from the 3rd to the 28th of October. Just let me introduce ourselves. I'm Sabrina Leone from the Università Politecnica delle Marche and Giovanni Biancofiore, the technical tutor of this course, is a Microsoft Certified System Administrator. He is from giovannibiancofiore.com. The general goals of SSW4LL 2011. It's an introductory course to social semantic web concepts and tools to support lifelong learners, that is yourselves, in characterizing your personal learning environments. So you will analyze the latest research literature and evaluate it against your own experience out and within this metacognitive learning path, with the intent of developing a comprehensive understanding of social semantic web and of getting tools for flexible and personalized learning or self-learning. The participants. So this course is thought for lifelong learners who are expert ICT and or e-learning professionals, but novice in social semantic web. The objectives of this course: acquire knowledge about a social semantic web, so definitions, languages, tools and projects for e-learning, and acquire further awareness, for those who already have it, about the characterization of one's personal learning environment. The competences: being able to characterize one's personal learning environment and being able to choose, implement and use social semantic web tools in your learning paths appropriately. The learning environment will be made up of Moodle 2, Semantic Media Wiki, Digo and Google Plus in detail. Moodle 2 will be used as a formal learning environment with learning resources recommended according to an entry learning style and a prior knowledge test. And Semantic Media Wiki will be used to search, organize, tag, browse, evaluate and share the wiki's content by added semantic annotations, so it's a collaborative database. Digo's wall group will allow us to collect, tag, comment and share interesting resources diffused online. And finally, Google Plus will be used to informally interact with one's circles through chat, video huddle, posts, video, photo sharing, and enrich in this way one's personal learning environment. Time schedule and contents. We're going through 4 weeks. This one will be the first one, actually it's week zero, starting Monday the 3rd of October. We will have time for technology familiarization with the learning environment. Week 1, starting on Monday the 10th of October, will be about the evolution from the social web to the semantic web and to the social semantic web. So we'll try to define them and find out more. Week 2, starting on Monday the 17th of October, will be fully focused on the semantic web. So we're going to talk about a lot of things. I'm not going to discover too much during this presentation, so we will find out more together. And finally, week 3 will start on Monday the 24th of October and will be focused on where the social web meets the semantic web. The methodology: social constructivism, so we'll use social construction of knowledge through learner-centered environment, collaborative and cooperative learning, brainstorming, problem-solving, situated learning and learning by doing. Self-assessment mainly, so basically through an entry test on learning styles and prior knowledge that will be held in week 1, and tests at the end of each week. The evaluation of the course will be based on an entry survey on your expectations about the course and about your way of organizing your personal learning environment, and will be based on a final feedback survey. So let's start out. This is what you're going to visualize entering the environment, our main environment, that is Moodle 2, starting from tomorrow. Just please note that only section 1 will be visualized, the other parts will be grayed out. So we're going to have 4 sections in Moodle 2, and in this one you will find introduction and guidelines, so you'll have links to all the tools we're going to use within the learning environment, and you can find here also links to the user guides. Let's warm up then. So during this first week, please stroll around section 1, which is introduction and guidelines. Get familiar with the main tools we're going to use in this learning environment. Edit your profile in the different accounts you've created: Moodle, Digo, Google+. Introduce yourself in the forum discussions. Ask for technical help in the forum provided. Contribute, share new resources, tutorials, guidelines about SWOL tools. So enjoy! Thank you.